An economic system is the way that a nation organizes, manages, controls the factors of production so that wealth or materials that get produced within the nation are somehow distributed to members of that population. Now, the method that gets used to manage these factors of production and to determine who gets what is really what defines a different economic system. So, two ends of a spectrum. We can think about command economies versus a market economy. Now, a command economy is an economic system where the government manages all, or in some cases, most, of the resources within the nation and oversees the types of industries that are going to operate. In a market economy, government is not involved. The resources within that nation get distributed, shared within society, based on this notion of supply and demand. So command economies, let's look a bit closer. Two types. First type is communism. Under communism, the government owns all of the factors of production and makes all the decisions on how resources within that nation will be used. Socialism could be thought of as a watered-down version of communism in many ways. Government controls the critical industries, but it does allow individual freedom, some individual right to own property, to start up small businesses that the government doesn't consider to be critical to the overall economy. So communism, how does it work? Well, we could think about this idea of an entrepreneur coming up with an idea, in our case, opening up a coffee shop, purchasing some land, and getting a business up and running. Well, in communism, that wouldn't happen. Why? Government controls all of the factors of production, makes all the decisions about which industries are going to operate. So the government would determine how the factors of production get utilized. So who gets capital? How does that capital get used to build certain industries? Government under communism owns all the resources and makes decisions that hopefully are going to benefit the most people within society. No individual ownership. It's about what's good for all of society, not necessarily what's good for the individual. So an example, suppose it's middle of winter, and you've got a tree out in your backyard and you need firewood. So you go out back, decide to chop up the tree, and have some firewood for your home. Under communism, that would be considered illegal. It's not your tree to chop down, it's the tree of the people. You just happen to be living in that house, which, by the way, also is owned by the people. Under communism, the government would determine how many farmers there needs to be, how many employees are needed to go work in a factory, who's going to be a teacher. Everyone needs to go to school, so government's going to oversee and provide all that too. So government's controlling one of the factors of production called labor. What happens to the output once industry is made the products it needs to make, once all the farmers have grown their food, the students have been educated, and so forth? Well, suppose those boxes on the screen are representative of the output of the economic system. Under communism, every member in society would be entitled to an equal share of what was produced within that economic system over the course of a year or a specific period of time. Everyone gets the same amount. The second example of a command economy is socialism. Remember, socialism? The government controls critical industries, but individuals are allowed to run non-critical businesses. So in our case, government has determined that a certain factory will get built, making a product that the people need, will provide jobs to citizens. Effectively, they are employees of the government. An employee gets hired to be a teacher, a certain number of people get hired to work on the farm. One individual decides they don't want to do that. They've got a musical talent and they choose to use that talent to earn a living. So what happens in socialism is the members of society get an equal share of what society produced. However, individuals who do choose to pursue businesses that are considered to be non-critical to the overall economic system are welcome to pursue their musical talent or to pursue this other type of smaller business and sell their talents to the rest of the population. A market economy. Market economies are the other end of the spectrum. In a market economy, government is not involved. The market is the mechanism of the exchange of goods and services, and resources are distributed by this concept of supply and demand. There's private ownership of everything. So, in our case, the entrepreneur has an idea. They want to get a coffee shop up and running. They need to be able to access capital. They need to be able to access labor. They need to be able to access natural resources. And everything has a price. As long as the entrepreneur is able to raise the capital in order to borrow money, pay the interest back, hire the labor to do the work, purchase the natural resources required to build the coffee shop and to keep it running, they're more than welcome to do that. In a market economy, it's all about private ownership. You have a tree in your backyard, you decide you want to go out and chop the tree down for firewood, you're more than welcome to do that. In fact, you're more than welcome to chop all the trees down on your property and do whatever you want to do with it. In a market economy, there's a price for everything. Now suppose the farmer wants to send his daughter to school to get an education. Well, there's a price for that education. How is he going to afford to do this? Well, he produces his product. So in our case, our farmer produces milk, and it's got a price. The farmer takes the milk to market, tries to make it available for sale to see who would be willing to buy it. Everyone's got freedom. Some people are going to say no. Some people are going to say yes. Farmer's daughter gets to go to school. Now, why would the farmer want to send his daughter to school in the first place? What is the point of education in a market economy? Opportunity. Education will create an individual that has more skills, more knowledge, all the credentials that an employer are looking for. They're then more likely to command a higher wage and generate more money in the long run so that they can in turn purchase more goods. Versus the individual who didn't get education. Now, how is the output in a market economy allocated within society? Those who produce, those who add value, those who have skills that are in short supply get the benefits of what the market economy has produced. Those who are unable to work, those who lack the education, don't benefit as much under a market economy. This produces the haves and the have-nots. Now, advantages of communism versus market economies. In communism, the wealth of the nation, what's been produced within that economic system, is shared equally amongst all members of society. Now, in market economies, what's the advantage? We get what we deserve. This notion of a student who studied very, very hard for an exam versus the student who didn't study at all and barely attended class. Disadvantages of communism and market economies. Under communism, everyone gets the same, regardless of how much they contributed, regardless of how hard they worked, regardless of how smart they are. It's all about equality. So in this case, the student who didn't do any work got a B, but so did the student who worked very hard. There's little motivation. In market economies, big downside is the potential for greed and all the negative things that can happen along with that greed. Is there a way to blend the best parts of each of these systems? This is called a mixed economy. In a mixed economy, it is an economic system that features characteristics of both command and market economies. What's interesting is most of the economies in the world are in fact mixed economic systems. They have elements of the market economy, but they also have elements of a command economy where government gets involved. This even includes the United States and Canada, two economic systems that we tend to view as being very capitalistic. So Canada has a mixed economy. In what ways is Canada's economy like a command economy? Well, government manages and regulates the businesses. There's a whole variety of rules and regulations and laws that various levels of government within Canada impose upon business. It keeps our water clean. It prevents people from going out and chopping down all the trees and ruining wildlife habitat, and ensures that the products that we purchase are safe. So all these rules are imposed by government in order to look after the best interests of all of society. Government is also the provider of essential services in Canada and in any mixed economic system. Government builds roads, provides the police force, hospital, prints the money. Can you imagine a private corporation in charge of printing the nation's money? Now, in what ways is Canada's economy like a market economy? Well, if mom and dad have enough money to send the student to school, and they work hard, and they get a good education, hopefully they get a job that allows them to make more money. They can buy a fancier car than those who haven't worked as hard or haven't been fortunate enough to go to school. And they can live in and purchase nicer homes. People who are unable to go to school for a variety of reasons, people who don't work hard, may not get a job that they like. May not be able to afford fancy cars. And may not have comfortable or luxurious living conditions. So to review, we could view economic systems as being two ends of a spectrum. So the high government control end of the spectrum, command economies. Two examples, communism and socialism. Opposite end of the spectrum, where it's low government control, the market economy. Somewhere in the middle, a mixed economy.